Friends, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I want to welcome you to this online service of worship for July 24th, 2022 for Riverside United Church, an affirming community of faith in London, Ontario. My name is Dave Exley, and I'm the lead minister for Riverside, and I hope you feel a sense of God's Spirit lifting you up today through the words that we share, the songs that we sing, all that we have to offer today. Well, today for us here in London, for us at Riverside, it's Pride Sunday. That Sunday where we celebrate the gift of God's expansive love that knows no boundaries. Celebrating Pride means that we take a positive stance against discrimination and violence towards LGBTQ+ individuals. Celebrating Pride also provides for us a chance to promote self-affirmation, dignity, equality, and fundamental human rights, and the freedom to celebrate in a safe environment. As an affirming community of faith, we work hard to celebrate the richness that diversity brings to our church, and we believe that diversity makes us stronger and better equipped to do God's work in the world. And so, friends, giving thanks for the gift of love, which is rooted in God, let us open our service in song.
God of the sparrow, God of the whale, God of the swirling stars, how does the creature say, ah? How does the creature say praise? God of the earthquake, God of the storm, God of the trumpet blast, how does the creature cry woe? How does the creature cry save? God of the rainbow, God of the cross, God of the empty grave, how does the creature say grace? How does the creature say thanks? God of the hungry, God of the sick, God of the prodigal, how does the creature say care? How does the creature say life? God of the neighbor, God of the foe, God of the brooding hook, how does the creature say love? How does the creature say peace? God of the ages, God near at hand, God of the loving heart, how do your children say joy? How do your children say home?
A reading from Matthew chapter 10, verses 40 to 42. Reading from the Common English Bible. Those who receive you are also receiving me, and those who receive me are receiving the one who sent me. Those who receive a prophet as a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. Those who receive a righteous person as a righteous person will receive a righteous person's reward. I assure you that everybody who gives even a cup of cold water to these little ones because they are my disciples, they will be certainly rewarded. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God. And friends, let us pray. O creative God, source of all beauty, you give light to the soul. Open our hearts as we listen for your word, and open our minds as we dream with you. Reveal your life-giving truth that comforts and disturbs us through Jesus the Christ. Amen. Well, have you ever had an epic fail when attempting to greet another person? I had one such moment during my time working for St. John's Presbyterian Church in Devon, Pennsylvania. My partner, Betsy, and I were working in team ministry together in those days with the children and the youth of the congregation. Well, a local artist, so the story goes, and a member of the church was busy completing a mural project in the carriage house of the church's campus. It was to be a beautiful tribute to the story of creation that filled the stairwell and the hallway that led to each of the classrooms used for the Sunday school program with a sense of light, color, and love. Well, one Saturday evening, while the mural project was still in the process of being finished, Betsy and I had to make a quick trip to the church building just to drop off a few supplies for the next morning. As we drove up to the carriage house, we noticed that Kathy, the artist working on the mural, that her car was in the parking lot. So we stepped out of the car and we could see as we looked into the building that there was light coming from the second floor of the building. But it did look like Kathy was about to finish for the night as a few classroom lights flicked off as we approached the building. As we entered the carriage house, I believe our initial plan was to walk upstairs to let Kathy know we were there, to see how the final stages of the project were going. But just before we flicked the light switch on in the main floor, one of us, I can't remember who, said, "Let's leave the lights off and surprise Kathy as she walks down the stairs." Without thinking too much about what we were about to do, we walked toward the stairwell in the darkness and kneeled behind one of the couches there. The next few seconds seemed to pass by in slow motion. As we crouched down, I can remember thinking to myself, "Is this a good idea?" But before my brain could process that question, Kathy emerged from the base of the stairwell into the darkness, and we stood up in dramatic fashion and shouted, "Surprise!" What followed was both comical and slightly embarrassing. Kathy shrieked and collapsed immediately, dropping the supplies she had in her hands as she fell to the ground in terror. To this day, I have not seen someone with such a look of fear, a look of horror on their face. I'm not even sure we actually finished saying surprise before immediately shifting gears, realizing what we had done. Everything unfolded rather quickly that night as we shifted from one emotion to the next, deeply regretting not thinking things through before Kathy emerged from the darkness. Now, I will say, despite the terror of the moment, we did share a good laugh amid the roller coaster of emotions that we experienced that evening. Thankfully, grace worked in our favor, and all was well in the end. But I'm not sure you'll find a more comical example of how not to greet others in the world of the church and really anywhere. Learn from our mistake. Don't do what we did. The passage we just heard from the Gospel of Matthew deals with the question, how do we greet? How do we receive others as people of faith? What does it mean to represent Christ in our daily lives? And where is God in the midst of our daily interactions with strangers, neighbors, friends, and more? Jesus reminds us that each and every one of our interactions with others has divine implications. In welcoming, in receiving others, we welcome God. In this short two-verse passage from Matthew 10, we hear this repetitive invitation that Jesus makes to his followers. The Common English Bible translates the word receive. Other translations read welcome. Whatever word you choose to use for this passage, it's clear that the key to what Jesus is saying is to be found in that word. He says, "Those who receive you are also receiving me. And those who receive me are receiving the one who sent me. Those who receive a prophet as a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And those who receive a righteous person as a righteous person will receive a righteous person's reward. 8 times Jesus uses this word in the passage. I like that the Common English Bible uses receive rather than welcome, what we hear in other translations. We tend to overuse the word welcome when it comes to the church. Welcome seems more like something we do to another person. It's an action that seems limited in our modern day context. To receive someone, in my view, means more than that. It means that we open ourselves to the other and to transformation ourselves. A part of that person becomes a part of us. We make space for them to enter in and forever change who we are. The word that Jesus uses and the way he addresses his followers gives us a glimpse of what it means to be a follower in the way. To be faithful in the way of Jesus demands that we push past ourselves, past our own small-minded way of thinking, in order that we might greet and receive the divine presence that exists within others. The interesting thing about our practices of receiving others, of greeting people, is that it reveals a great deal about how we approach God and creation. It makes a statement about what we believe, the way we receive others. When we greet people with love, particularly those who are strangers or those who are estranged from us, we proclaim God's original blessing. When we greet people with disdain or hatred or those other emotions in our hearts, we proclaim the opposite. Not original blessing, but original sin. Consider how the resurrected Christ greeted his followers. Jesus, upon the resurrection, when the world greeted him with violence, he responded with love, with grace, with peace. Rather than responding to the darkness with more darkness, Jesus offered light to all the world. In doing this, he helped to show us what lies at the heart of all creation, of all people. Light, goodness, a divine peace of God. Bishop Will Willimon once shared a story about a time when he was a young pastor serving in a small rural congregation in the South for the Methodist Church. One night after an unusually difficult church business meeting, Willimon was out front of the church changing the lettering on the church sign. The members had all gone home, and he stood there alone and frustrated as he changed the letters to spell out the title of the sermon for the upcoming Sunday. As he worked in this disheartened fashion, Willimon suddenly sensed he wasn't alone. He looked up and saw a strange-looking man standing next to him. The man looked disheveled. He had a worn-out old hat and a tattered suit. Willimon couldn't help but wonder if the man was homeless. The man proceeded to ask Willimon a question. He said, "Are you the preacher here?" "Yes, I am," Will said. The stranger then proceeded to say something unexpected. He said, "I just stopped by to tell you not to be discouraged. You're doing a good job, and I'm proud of you." Willimon asked the man who he was and was taken aback when the man answered, "I'm Jesus." Willimon stood there speechless while the stranger just walked away, heading down the road without any visible means of transportation, waiting for him. When Willimon returned home, he said to his wife, "The weirdest thing happened to me just a few minutes ago at the church. A strange old man came up to me and told me not to be discouraged and that I was doing a good job. And then, to top it off, he told me that he was Jesus." His wife quite seriously answered him, "And how do you know it wasn't?" One of the most important things we can do as people of faith is consider the way we greet others, the way we receive one another. Do we extend peace and grace to all, or do we limit God's love? One of my favorite hymns from our denominational hymn book, Voices United, is God of the Sparrow. I love that each stanza in the hymn ends with a question. More songs of faith should do that in my mind. In the song, we sing lines like, how does the creature say awe? How does the creature say praise? How does the creature say love? How does the creature say peace? How do your children say joy? How do your children say home? Those questions might be the best questions we can ask as we attempt to faithfully follow in the footsteps of Jesus. Those are the questions that will help us as we attempt to do a better job of greeting and receiving others. If we can learn how to say praise, how to say love, how to say joy, how to say home, God's divine presence will no doubt be present with us along the road of life. Let's go back to that story I shared in the beginning. If you ever find yourself struggling to receive others in the way that Christ commands us, perhaps you can do the thing that I failed to do that night as I hid in the darkness of our church carriage house. Before you greet the person, think about the divine presence in them. Consider how you might honor them and not scare the daylight out of them. It's helpful, if it's helpful. Sing those questions from that song, God of the Sparrow. How does the creature say love? How does the creature say peace? In your heart, sing those songs. In your head, sing that song. Do that. Doing that might guide you to a place where you might be able to share those life-giving words of Christ. Don't be discouraged. You're doing a good job. I'm proud of you. Those words might just be the cup of cold water that the other person so desperately needs to quench their thirsty soul. Amen.
Changing. Your love is a mountain firm beneath my feet. Your love is a mystery, how you gently lift me. When I am surrounded, your love carries me. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Joy that's growing deep inside of me. Every time I see you, all your goodness shines through. I can feel this God song rising up in me. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing hallelujah. Gently lifts me when I am surrounded. Your love carries me. We sing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing.
Friends, as we give thanks this day for the gift of love and for the opportunity to share God's good word with others, to remind people of that original blessing that Christ came to proclaim, May you go from this place in hope, and may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of God's Spirit. Amen.